Marshall has really shined through this season. Quarterback Rakeem Cato broke that NCAA record earlier this season for consecutive games with a touchdown pass. Devin Johnson really helped their offense for both passing and running the ball. Their defense shined through a lot this season, but that WKU game, can they rebound?
I think that's the big thing. I mean, it's not the fact that you lose, it's how you lose, and how are you going to rebound from that mentally? Rakeem Cato coming off a great game as far as throwing 7 touchdown passes, but the picks were not good. How is he going to mentally get over that? And we don't know the health of Devin Johnson coming into this game. If they have him, that increases their chances, I think. I mean, Butler did a great job running, don't get me wrong, but he's going up against a defense now that is solid. They are stout. They take the ball away from you, but I think you got this great prolific offense of Marshall. You look at the numbers for Marshall, they rank 7th in rushing offense, 2nd in total offense, in scoring offense. This is a big time offense, but can they get over the mental hump of what happened last week? And we've talked all year long, you can't let a team beat you twice. It's gonna be a very important time, I think, for Marshall, just mentally get over what happened.
They have a lot of preparation this week, but Marshall was the preseason favorite, as I mentioned earlier this season, but someone wasn't too happy about Louisiana Tech coming in at 4. How much better do you think the Bulldogs will be with that added year of experience going into his second season?
A lot better. Louisiana Tech, they're starting to get that confidence. We said at the beginning of the year they would be the surprise of the league. I think they may be on the road to doing that.
What do you know? He was right. Is that knowledge or luck, old wise one?
No, I know I've mentioned it already, but when they played Oklahoma, they're playing in front of 80,000-plus fans. It's the first game of the year. Everybody's all hyped up. Yes, they lost the football game, but I think all of us that were doing the game saw something very special in Louisiana Tech. Number one, I saw leadership. I saw Cody Sokol coming in his first year, the transfer. He was just outstanding. He took guys and said, okay, we're gonna keep fighting. And then you look at defensive lineman Houston Bates, another transfer, and the leadership he provided on defense. Something just clicked inside of all of us that were watching that game and said, this is a team that's going to compete for a championship come the end of the year.
But you've been covering Conference USA for quite a while, and you saw Skip Holtz bring now 2 teams to the championship game, ECU in 08 and 09. And like legendary coach Tom Landry said, when you get to the end zone, act like you've been there before, and he certainly has.
He really has. And I think when you talk to Skip, the first thing he does is give credit to his assistant coaches. The job Manny Diaz has done on the defensive side has been outstanding. I mean, he had these guys playing fast, started out with a very simple scheme. They started to get more complicated as things went on, but he gives credit to those guys, and also he gives credit to the leaders of this football team. Skip kind of deflects the credit, but the bottom line is Skip Holtz has done an outstanding job this season and deserves whatever awards he's going to get.
Marshall is definitely going to need to look out for the La Tech defense. But Ron, what are the keys to the game for both teams to walk away with a win?
Well, here's a little stat I want to mention, that when Skip Holtz was at East Carolina, played in 2 championship games, he was the underdog in both of those games. He'll come into this game as the underdog. The bottom line is, can the Louisiana Tech defense continue the trend of not only forcing turnovers, but making them pay on the offensive end for Marshall? They've got to get back to what they've done defensively. They were a great defensive team up until this past week. Get back to the fundamentals, just tackling, just playing fast. Can they do that, and can they get over the mental hump of what happened last week? But it's going to be a great game, and I'd like to make a prediction, but I like both coaches, so I'm not.
Fans, once again, mark your calendars. December 6th, the 2014 Conference USA Football Championship game will air at noon Eastern from Joan C. Edwards Stadium in Huntington, West Virginia. We look forward to seeing you all there.